Dear guest, the last paper of this session is increasing the by Özlem Özgenç. Okay, Özlem. Özlem, are you there? Özlem?
Yes, I'm here. Yes, just a minute.
All right, so please, yes, you can start.
Yes. Okay. Hello, dear participant. Welcome to my presentation. I will tell you about our study titled Increasing the Outdoor Durability of Euroformaldehyde Particle Boards with New Generation Waterborne Acrylic Coatings. Melamine formaldehyde glue moisture resistance is relatively higher than euroformaldehyde glue moisture resistance. Particle board panels produced with melamine formaldehyde can be used in semi-open outdoor conditions and indoor structures, except for common usage areas where there may be hot, cold water leaks, moisture deposits, or steam. In this study, it is aimed to increase the resistance of euroformaldehyde particle board to semi-open outdoor condition by applying waterborne acrylic coatings.
Özlem, can you make a full screen for your presentation?
I'm sorry. You can see. Can you see my presentation?
You can see your presentation, but can you make a full screen?
Okay, just a minute. Okay.
Okay, thanks.
The industrial wood particles obtained from a commercial particle board plant were used as a raw material for particle board manufacturing. The particle boards were produced under commercial conditions at Starwood Forest Products Company, Bursa, Turkey. Particle and clipping were blended with synthesized euroformaldehyde resin and melamine formaldehyde resin with a solid content of 65%. Three layered boards were pressed under 220 centigrade press temperature, 55 second press time, and 3 Newton second millimeter pressure produced 280 and 210 and 0.8 centimeter dimensions. After pressing, particle board were conditioned at a temperature of 20 centigrade and 65% relative humidity. Coating systems, we use two acrylic resins, acrylic eco resins, pure acrylic, and constrile acrylic, acrylic emissions. And we use UV absorber kinoin. Formulations, you can see in table these formulations. Total four we product four coating systems. For example, X-coating systems, different percent we use acrylic, and AX different different percent acrylic, and we examined coating systems, X coating systems, solid content 39, AX 30, A 44, and then other other combinations 35 solid content pH. They are close pH values, viscosity different. Article weathering test. Article weathering test. We use ASTM standard. Total 288 hours. We exposed panels, weathering tests, 8 replicate samples for each coating system were prepared for each article weathering condition. Article weathering was performed in a QUV spray acrylic weathering tester equipped with 318 nanometer fluorescent UVB lamp, 60 centigrade temperature. Surface roughness test, we used Mitutoya surface instrument, the RR and RB roughness parameters we measured to evaluate the surface roughness of the surface of unweathering and weathered coated particle board and uncoated particle board samples according to DIN standards. Physical and mechanical tests, the duplicate panels were made. For each group, panels were kept in conditioned room with a relative humidity of 65% and a temperature 20 centigrade until they reached equilibrium moisture content. They were then cut in test samples based on standards. We measured models of elasticity and models of rupture from static bendings, and then internal bond strength and thickness swelling after 24-hour immersion of the samples were determined. 10 samples were cut from test panels to measure physical and mechanical tests. Mechanical tests were performed on universal instrument testing machine. In the table, physical and mechanical test results of test and control panels before and after weathering tests are given. Now let's examine the change in mechanical stretch values of a panel on this feature. As can be seen in figure, mechanical stretch loss in a coated euroformaldehyde particle boards in quite low compared to euroformaldehyde control panels. It is close to melamine formaldehyde panels for mechanical strength change. The least change in thickness swelling values after weathering occurred in melamine formaldehyde boards. However, the thickness swelling swelling values of coated panels are lower than the euroformaldehyde control panels. You can, as you see in this table, the loss change in surface roughness values after weathering test was determined in coated euroformaldehyde particle boards. However, it was found that the roughness values of melamine formaldehyde control panels was also lower than that of euroformaldehyde control panels. Conclusion of this study: after exposure to the artificial weathering test, the percentage of decrease in the physical and mechanical strain of euroformaldehyde particle board applied the waterborne acrylic coatings is close with melamine formaldehyde particle boards. The fact that waterborne acrylic coatings are renewable can make progress in the particle board industry. The coating materials we have applied have a positive effect on the aging property of the particle board. By increasing the durability period, longer lasting boards can be obtained compared to melamine formaldehyde particle board. This difference in usage time can make the difference in cost negligible. Thank you for your listening.
Thank you very much, Özlem, for this presentation.